wipes away the beads of sweat that glistened on his brow. His tired feet were buried in the quagmire, and his bloodshot eyes saw all that lay between him and fulfillment of his vow. And he felt his fingers wrap around the knotted roof and pull his body upwards to a sea green mossy boulder, and he dragged his weary shit ass up the mountain, and he climbed so slowly, he climbed so slowly, the crack of thunder, and the rocks began to crumble overhead and tumble down the mountain to the dismal swamp that lay beneath the jagged cliffs through which his path had led. And the earth began to quake beneath his feet, and the mighty mountain changed before his eyes, and he stood amidst a sea of dust and rocks and stones cascading down the mountain, and 1,000 birds were headed for the sky. Whoa. The sacred creed will be yours. And if you wait until tomorrow, the sacred creed will be yours to devour, yours to seize and to obey. Up his head and was driven to his knees by a blazing beam of light, and he saw the silhouette that stood before him, and he bowed in reverence, trembling in the shadow of the mighty legend's form. Iculus the prophet stood before his eyes, looking down on Colonel Corbin, where he shuddered in the puddles and the muck. And he quietly addressed him, and he spoke so slowly, he spoke so slowly, he said. Why you've come here, and I'll help you with your quest to gain the knowledge that you lack. I call upon my faithful friend, the Mockingbird, to fly and seize the helping book and bring it to your shack. And the tree of knowledge in your soul will grow, and the helping friendly book will plant the seed. But I warn you that all knowledge seeming innocent and pure becomes a deadly weapon in the hands of avarice and greed. Whoa. The sacred greed will be yours. You wait until tomorrow, the sacred greed will be yours to devour, yours to seize and to obey.
This is the last gig that we're playing in Colorado. And we want to thank you guys all for a really great time. Telluride, Boulder, and Denver, and the Gothic Theater, and the Colorado College, and everybody. I definitely recognize a lot of faces that were around, and made a lot of friends, so thank you so much. We're going to drive to Austin, Texas tonight after the gig, and it's going to be a whole new thing. Now, we couldn't resist playing this song on the last night because of anywhere, at least in this country, people who understand about the spirit of the mountain. There's no place more than Colorado that people understand that. So we thought it would be appropriate that we played this song on the last night. And some of you know about this and some of you don't. I'm going to tell you what it's really about. Now, this is about another place, and where we come from, we know about the spirit of the mountain too. But anyway, if you come with us now to a different place, the different mountains, this is Gamehenge that we're going to. And at Gamehenge, as most of you know probably, it started out a long time ago as a beautiful, beautiful, serene wonderland of beauty and peace and harmony. The people that lived there, the people of Gamehenge, the lizards, lived in harmony, peace and harmony with nature for thousands of years. And they lived in a place where you had a big, vast green forest and a huge fields off at the end of the forest that reached out. And of course, in the middle of the field was the big black rhombus, in which they used to, a long time ago, the people would go up to the mountain and they would pray to the gods and try to keep in harmony with the mountain. And every year they had a ritual where they would go out to the field, climb up on the rhombus and sing the divided sky prayer to the sky above them. Now later on, after all this happened, of course, the traveler came to Gamehenge named Wilson. And Wilson saw these innocent people, and instead of seeing it as a beautiful thing in harmony with nature, he saw it as an opportunity to oppress and exploit these people. So what he did was he took their book, or their Bible of sorts, the Helping Friendly Book, which had been given to them thousands of years ago by the great knowledgeable Iculus, whose spirit lived on top of the mountain that rose out of the forest there. And he took the book and he stole it from them because he knew that without the book, they were helpless and they would need to come to him. So by stealing the book, he enslaved all the people of Gamehenge. And he hid the book in a castle. He chopped down all the trees and raised a castle in the middle of a clearing in the middle of the forest. And for years and years, he had enslaved the people until finally Colonel Forbin, who's the hero of this last song that I was just singing about, made it into Gamehenge. And he decided that he would help a group of revolutionaries try to overthrow Wilson. A lot of attempts failed, and finally his last attempt was going to be to climb up the mountain, which no one had ever done before, and try to find the great knowledgeable Iculus and ask for help. So as it says in the last song, he climbs up the mountain begins to quake and rumble, rocks tumbling down around him. He's on his knees looking up in awe as the mountain begins to take the form of Iculus's face, little pieces falling out until the whole mountain becomes the face of the great knowledgeable Iculus. And Colonel Forbin is kneeling there in terror beneath this awesome sight. And Iculus says to Colonel Forbin, I'm going to help you. I'm going to call my friend, the famous Mockingbird, who's going to fly down. I'm going to send him off to steal the Helping Friendly book back from Wilson and bring it to the evil people. But of course, he does give him that one warning that this book contains all the knowledge inherent in the universe, and knowledge in the wrong hands, in the hands of avarice and greed, becomes a deadly weapon, so you better beware. But that's a whole different part of the story. You can worry about that later, but right now the famous Mockingbird is flying out of the ground, out of the sky, to go to the castle and steal the friendly book. Thank you.
truth in action. Let's see. Today.